But what I think we're in is in an air pocket. You know, the last 2 weeks of the end of the quarter and the first 2 weeks of the next quarter, the market gets pushed around by the headlines because we're earnings season's over. Now we're waiting for the next earnings season to come about. And that's where we'll find out where the rubber meets the road about companies' forecasts of what's actually happening in the economy and how it's impacting corporate cash flows.
How are we set up for earnings? Do you think that with the big pullback we saw late last year that it's an easy beat, or there's still that sort of bearish sentiment out there that just any kind of cut in guidance or negative comments spooks the market?
So what we saw more true than any other quarter was it's all about future guidance. This quarter's earnings are going to be really sloppy. You have so many cross currents, right? Or the price of oil is down 50% in one quarter. You have the dollar strengthening, which is going to impact FX rates on conversions, right? You have now the tariffs have marinated for one full quarter at higher levels. That's going to impact company margins. So I would expect this quarter's earnings to be really messy. The glue is going to be what's on future guidance. That's going to be the key.
JJ, where is retail investor sentiment right now?
Well, retail investor sentiment, we came out our IMX today, which measures that. And what we saw was our clients pull back about 16% last month in terms of their overall exposure. The interesting thing about what they've done recently is they got out of some equity names and they rolled it into more index-based ETFs and fixed income. So obviously a little bit of fear, you know, which makes sense. 3 months in a row, the entire of the fourth quarter of 2018, every month was a little bit less exposure than the month before. What's interesting to me is if I look at some of the stocks they did buy, one of the ones leading the way is AT&T, which hit a 52-week low and at the same time does provide some
yield. Is that a dividend play?
Exactly it, Sarah. It provides a dividend play. Apple, which, you know, they came in to buy. It's a stock that it was our number one held stock the last 2 years. The first dip they bought, they stopped for a while. Then this last dip again, they came in and bought again. And, you know Altria, obviously with the news with Jewel, and then GE, as it got to $7 and below, people still want to believe in that story overall.